Nine's Wide World of Sports from historic and hallowed Lord's, the first test between England and India.
Welcome to Nine's Wide World of Sports and to the highlights of the second day's play in the Test match at Lord's, the Cornhill Test between England and India. The first day was quite a remarkable one, some very exciting cricket, with England, after being in a disastrous position early on, finishing up at 278 for six, with Derek Randall playing a great innings there, a comeback to Test cricket, 84 not out, and Phil Edmonds in the tail coming up with 59 not out. It was the middle order that saved England, after they were 37 for three at one stage. Well, conditions on this second day just about perfect, although there was some talk perhaps there might be a shower later in the day, but there'd been a little bit of overnight rain. Wasn't expected to inconvenience the bowlers at all, with the ball being wet, and certainly it hadn't got through to the pitch. Here's the first ball of the morning now. Kapil Dev is the bowler, and Derek Randall on 84 is taking strike. With me in the commentary box is Brian Close.
Side of the ground. Picks up three runs. Goodall Parker, the fielder. Good shot, good running, and a nice pick up and throw way down here at deep fine leg. Martin Lowell. That's a fine stroke. Splitting the field on the offside. Yashpal Sharma and Ashok Malhotra. No chance there. Yashpal Sharma in the end chasing to the boundary.
Nice little outswinger bowled well up, and Derek playing like a man in form and timing it beautifully, beating three people out on the offside.
It's down the leg side, it's caught by Kiamani. Edmonds didn't even bother to look round. Kiamani had no doubt that the inside edge had carried the ball to him. And it's 291 for seven. And a great partnership broken here at Lord's.
First breakthrough for India this morning, and a vital one with this second new ball, which now is 13 overs old. Solid stroke from Bob Taylor. Randall's looking for three, but there's no chance of that. Typical limited over ploy of looking as though he's going to charge for the third.
Well, Kapil Dev, being the senior bowler, must have the choice of ends. And I was quite surprised when he chose the nursery end yesterday to do about all his bowling. Because in the past, senior bowlers, number one fast bowlers, they nearly always choose the pavilion end.
Quickly into his stride for a single.
Well, we'll have to be quick here. I reckon Bob Taylor was gone and forgotten had that hit the stumps.
Well, I think Derek Randall was quite prepared to take it, but I think he took Bob Taylor a little by surprise with the call there. Because Bob half hesitated, and then seeing that Derek Randall was committed, was going and had the throw, hit the wickets, then I think Bob Taylor would have been continuing his run into the pavilion.
Two this time, and up comes the 300 for England. Philip Doshi, the fielder, way down at third man. The end of a couple of depths over. 301 for seven, four to Taylor now, and 96 to Derek Randall.
Randall facing Budwell. He's gone for it this time. Glorious shot through the covers by Derek Randall. The crowd immediately rising to their feet. Cheer Derek Randall on making 100 here in this Lord's Test match. Exactly 100 out of 307 for 7. And the superb innings by this Nottinghamshire batsman. His two previous hundreds at this level have both come against Australia. 1-6 and 8-4s in this knock today. And he's played supremely well. Real wild yahoo at that one. That's the last ball of Muddenwell's over. He'd made up his mind prior to the bowler bowling. Muddenwell taking a pretty poor view of that. The field's coming in just a shade, obviously intent on trying to keep Randall down that end. They don't want him to get too much of the bowling. And that's Randall's answer. And he's picked up four for it. Not the greatest of shots this time from Derek, but they all count. He got his feet in fairly awkward position there to play it. And the stroke repeated. Lovely piece of timing again by Randall. Everything absolutely right about it.
The umpires have been working overtime out there in this match so far. That's the first official warning for running on the pitch given to Dilip Doshi. 122 not out to Randall at the luncheon adjournment. Bob Taylor 26 with Philip Edmonds, the man out, for 64. And just two runs added from that point to take the total up to 354 for 7. Been warned, is coming into bowl to Derek Randall. And in the commentary box, it's Brian Close and Jim Laker.
So Doshi to Randall. Not for the first time, dropping that very wide outside leg stump. There's something gone slightly astray with the rhythm of Dilip Doshi in this test match. There's a pleasant sight. Start for Bob Taylor, a loosener there from Kapil Dev, who started bowling from this end. Nice, almost slow, medium, long hop from him. And he's gone. Nice little change of pace there and flight by Doshi. The first time caught Taylor in two minds, looking to push out, realised he was beaten in the flight, looked then for that little chop shot. And finish up giving a very simple catch to Vishwanathan slip. So Taylor goes for 31 and England now 363 for 8. For Randall, the gully's coming away. Parker coming round extra cover direction. Vinsaka going back to backward point. Has he taken it? Yes, Derek Randall didn't wait. Kapil Dev takes the wicket, brilliantly caught there by Parker.
a second hesitation from Derek Randall to see whether he'd snapped it up or not. And as soon as he was assured that the fielder had caught it, he was on his way for 126. Caught Parker bowled Kapildev. That's a fifth wicket in the innings for Kapildev. And the end of a really very fine innings from Derek Randall. Welcome back to Test Match Cricket. And already the crowd rising to their feet. A very popular character indeed, not only in his home county of Nottingham, but everywhere around the world. Great enjoyment to so many people with his fielding, and now he's proved here at Lord's that he can do it with a bat as well. He's gone for the big one. Tossed it up nicely. It's cleared everybody down there very safely, very comfortably, and it's over the ropes for six. That's a pretty big hit, that, from Paul Allott out to the long boundary here at Lord's.
Well, Paul Allott's a big, strong man, and he a little slow one thrown in and a couple of strides down, and he caught it as it was coming up and pulling it over wide of deep mid-on. Clear of the boundary.
Oh, that's a nice friendly full toss this time from Kapildev. Not the boot to it, but it still escaped him. So Bob Willis gets a four.
England for that single to Bob Willis, and much appreciated by the crowd. A good last wicket stand this, and a good recovery by the England team. And that's a new mark for the 10th wicket record against India. Paul Allott and Bob Willis now 58, beating the previous record, J.T. Murray and Robin Hobbs, established in 1967. Could be mud and lull now from the nursery end. 433 for nine. And there it is. End of the England innings. 433 all out, with mud and lull bowling Bob Willis for 28. That's great performance from the England batsman, 433 after being 37 for 3 on the first morning of this Lord's Test match. 126 for Randall, great comeback to Test cricket, 64 for Edmonds, 31 to Bob Taylor, 28 to Bob Willis, his best ever Test match score. Be nice to do that in your debut Test as captain. And the unbeaten man, Paul Allott, on 41, and he must be getting into the all-rounder class the way he's been batting in Test matches. The Indian bowlers, they started off well. Kapildev with three in the first session yesterday, finished with five for 125. Mud and Lull, three for 99. And Dilip Doshi, who was a little disappointing in this game, looked a touch nervous to me all the way through, two for 120. And Ravi Shastri struggled a little on this very good pitch, none for 73. Yashpal Sharma, no wicket for one.
To Parker. Oh, he's got that through. So no need for anybody to run there. There's no third man, of course. That array of slips, anything piercing them going at that sort of pace, is four runs.
Umpire Evans is coming down to have a word with Phil Edmonds.
The umpire might be saying that he's too close in. Not too sure about how Edmonds will take that. The umpire Evans at the bowler's end has gone down. They may well be asking that Edmonds make sure that he doesn't move as the stroke's being played. Vansaka is ready now. No ball. And one bouncer called in the over. I suppose a bouncer can be a no ball. Oh yes, must be. Got to be out that one. A lot of pressure on Vansaka out there. And Willis hit him in the pads earlier this over.
Was given not out and must have been very close, and that was absolutely plumb. Very good piece of bowling by Bob Willis, and it's 21 for 2.
It's Viswanath who is bowled by both of them, with one that came through round about shin height, I would think.
Well, Viswanath was never happy here, and he, with a high back lift, the ball sneaked through between bat and pad, hitting his off stump.
Beltham to Yashpal Sharma. And cut that into him. Yashpal Sharma just helping it round the corner.
And he's given out LBW. So Pringle on to start for him. Wicket in his first over. Yashpal Sharma, LBW to Pringle. The very last ball of his first over in Test match cricket. Reducing the Indians to something of a shambles here now at 31 for 4.
Well, lulled into false sense of security, Pringle pitched that ball well up. And again, the Indian batsmen are back on the back foot with a very near to those wickets.
Beltham quickly into action.
This is a man they'd like to see the back of, but lovely off drive there. Even Randall isn't bothering to chase that one. And he's nicely away. Once again, Randall has given up the unequal chase. Quickly races down to that Tuffin boundary and I'll hatch off the mark with 4. And that came back very sharply and the umpire's finger's gone up again. So Malhotra's turn this time to go out LBW. LBW to Pringle. 45 for 5.
Well, Pringle pitching went a little short outside the off stump, and then the batsman going back, it nipped down the hill quite considerably.
Well, there have been several good eight catches in the gully. That was very nearly another one by Alan Lamb.
And you can hear the round of applause. This really was a magnificent effort by Lamb. Short, Gavaskar cutting. And a tremendous effort there from Alaban.
Beautiful stroke there from Kapil Dev. Edmund's giving the ball plenty of air. India's all-rounder crashed it away through extra cover.
The perfect off drive. Beautifully in position.
It's a nice shot from Kapil Dev. It's going to be restricted to two. Very quick piece of chasing there from Derek Randall.
And what a day it was for England. 92 for 5, India. At the close of play on this second day, England having gone on to 433. And then 92 for 5 with the skipper, Gavaskar, 41 not out. I thought that was a very good innings. He fought hard out there, kept his head down and played extremely sensibly. And Kapil Dev, 28 not out in the face of some spirited England bowling. Bob Willis was very pacey, got a lot of bounce, and only Gavaskar was able to combat him. 1 for 19, both of them 2 for 32. 2 for 16 to Derek Pringle in his first test match. What a day for him. Edmonds and Allett didn't take a wicket, but there's still plenty of time for the box in this first.